when he flashes out that far.
And Moj, that's why all the time, if you got nothing, you just shoot five hole, and somehow, some way, it decides to go in.
Back to the Avalanche zone, Jack Johnson in his repaired face. Dishes off for McDonald. A little bit too far. Oh my goodness! A huge hit on Jacob McDonald, and he's out. Lomberg just laid him out, and here comes Obe Kubel. He is in trouble. We're going to have a fight far side. Obe Kubel's angry as heck. Couple of jabs there, and McDonald is down on the ice. He cannot get up. In the far circle, they'll continue to tilt, and then as Obe Kubel ends up on top of him. Trainers out now for Jacob McDonald. Oh my goodness gracious. A very scary hit inside the Avalanche zone. Florida Trainers coming out. Doctors are coming out. Ryan Lomberg came into the zone and just leveled Jacob McDonald. Oh, you hate to see that.
At any time, in any place, and head hits have been a hot topic for us here lately. We had Jacob Trouba that hit McKinnon, and the night before that, I believe it's Kahari, if I'm saying his name right, from Chicago.
Yeah, Jujar Kara.
And Lomberg's not a big guy. He's 5'9", 175. He's more of a veteran guy. He's older at 27 years, and the replay is going to show us all we need to see. What was the first point of contact? Was it through the body?
It was.
So, boy, he's out on impact. So here's what it's going to come down to, Moj. Boy, that's just... And by the definition of the rule book, that was no different than the McKinnon hit. It was clean. It was through the chest.
And I guess no different than the Kara hit either.
Yep. And McDonald gets caught with his head down. And my feeling, Moj, if these hits continue to happen, the NHL is going to move, and they're going to change their rule. Like they do in international hockey, you cannot make contact to the head at any time, no matter what. And maybe a lot of fans want that. I'm not sure, but that's a clean hit. And it always takes a few injuries, and then they change the rule. It's just the way that it has to happen. And scary deal, boy, and he was out before he went down. Thank goodness his helmet was buttoned tight.
That was very much like the hit on Kara by Jacob Trouba last week before he caught McKinnon on the following night.
But Moj, you agree, per the laws of the game, that's a clean hit. He comes right through the body.
It's impact with the chest and the head at the same time. And so you get the whole upper part of the torso and the head in one instance. And again, if it's going to be a penalty, it's going to be just head only. We just care about the health of Jacob McDonald and care about his care down there, as he was not moving for quite a while, and a lot of personnel came over. All the Avalanche personnel, you see all the Panthers personnel is also on the ice, and you're happy to see that. In this kind of situation, it is all hands on deck from all the medical personnel, as Lomberg is in the box now. Obe Kubel also in the box.
And Lomberg's not enjoying this as well. You're out there to play and compete. Whenever you see anybody injured to this magnitude, it always just kind of brings you back to the point that it's just a game. But it makes you wonder, Moj, is that something they're going to look at? Are they going to move to the international ice hockey rules eventually and just say no matter how vulnerable a guy leaves himself, are they going to eliminate hits to the head? So in this play, if you look, McDonald has no idea. He's got his head up. He sees him there, makes the pass. And then he let up any kind of defensive ability. So watch right here. Now his head's up. I think he sees him there. I don't know how he doesn't. But the way he takes the hit, I know as a hockey player, he left himself wide open and vulnerable. Heads up. He sees him. But then does nothing to get his hands up to protect himself of any kind, which makes me think then he didn't see him. But when you're stretched out, comes through the body.
They'll take Jacob McDonald off the ice on the stretcher. The fans give him a hand.
That's really
hope for the best. Yeah, they slide him on the ice until they get off the ice, and then they put him up. They don't want him sliding off, falling off the stretcher, or anything like that out there on the ice.
That happened to Mike Modano like 20 years ago. They had him on the stretcher, and then it slid over to the side, and six guys are trying to carry an injured guy in a neck brace, and the stretcher's on its side. That wasn't a good look.
No.
So the ambulance is right out there. It always sits there for every single game. We say hi to the guys on the way in, so he's got the best possible care that you can have, as all the professional sports do, junior as well. Yeah, it's just a bit of a shock and awe moment, isn't it?
That's what it is. It's such a startling situation when you see a guy out before he even hits the ice. And that was the case again with Jujhar Khera, and that was the case with Jacob McDonald. Luckily for the Avalanche, Nathan McKinnon was able to avoid that last week at Madison Square Garden.
And no suspension for Trouba on Khera or McKinnon. This right here, I would say a very similar hit. I don't imagine there's going to be any additional suspension. There's no additional penalty on the play besides the fight. So we'll take a big, tough sport here, Mo.